For fans of this beloved character, can you talk a little bit about what they can expect overall from this new beautiful adventure you've given us?
Well, it picks up the story of the Banks family several decades later, and the children are now grown up, obviously, and a tragedy has befallen them, and they're struggling with life. And in fact, the whole country is struggling. There's a depression. And just when things feel like they are getting to the point of true disaster, Mary Poppins descends from the sky on a kite. Thank goodness.
You talk a little bit about the magic of Mary Poppins and the magic of Emily Blunt, such a perfect fit for this character.
Yeah, she's magical, hilarious, beautiful, and creative. And who wouldn't want Emily Blunt to come into their lives and make it better?
There's a beautiful subtext in this story about rediscovering imagination. I guess my final question, can you talk a little bit about how much that was true for you on the set of this and working with these wonderful, talented people?
Well, I think to do this film, you had to, in a way, rediscover that feeling, because it really required you not to be cynical about anything. Not to, as Rob, the director, always said, we mustn't be winking or anything about it, or nodding, or it doesn't need to be sent up in any way. It has to have a sort of sincerity and come from the heart. So that makes you feel, you have to open your heart to that, yeah. Well, it was a very light set. The atmosphere was very good. It was very big, you know. There were lots of people working on this film, but I think one of the amazing things about the experience for me was that Rob Marshall, the director, was able to keep everybody invested. Everyone felt like they had something really important to give. And so I think when you have people who are happy and feeling like they're being creatively challenged and used, the atmosphere's good. Yeah.
What was it that convinced you to get involved in the film?
Rob Marshall and Emily Blunt.
Didn't take much persuasion.
Yeah, that was it. I think Rob Marshall's one of the best directors of movie musicals ever. And so I was keen to be a part of anything he wanted to make. And then I thought, Emily Blunt is perfect casting. Who else could play that role? So I was on board from that moment.
So you've gone back to your neutral accent tonight, but how did the London accent come along for the film?
Well, listen, I just spent the summer in Cardiff, actually. I'm working on a BBC series where I have a Texas accent. And I will tell you, it is harder to hang on to a Texas accent in Cardiff than it is to a London accent in London. So it was a joy, but it was really fun.
And was there anything that gave you inspiration to get that accent? Or did you watch any shows?
Yeah, it was a lot of listening to 1930s music, because it's not just the where of the accent, it's the when of the accent. So it was a lot of music hall recordings.
Lin, can you talk to us a little bit about what for you the quintessence of the magic, the essence of the magic of Mary Poppins is, and why the world still needs it 54 years later?
Yeah, well, I think that movie is so iconic, and since it's been around for 54 years, you know, generation upon generation has grown up with it. So I'm really excited that we have more adventures.
What makes Emily such an amazing talent?
Oh my God, I mean, who else could go from The Girl on the Train to Mary Poppins to A Quiet Place in a year? Nobody.
For fans of Mary Poppins, can you talk to us a little bit about where we find the Banks family at the start of this new event?
So, we find the family in a bit of distress. They have, it's a Sunday morning, it's early. Their sink has exploded, as Ellen says. My sink's exploded! And there's a banging at the door. They open the door, and it's the wolves, as they call them, with a hammer banging on the door with a notice of repossession piece of paper. And they kind of get a bit sad because it's the house that the mother was in, and the mother has passed away, and they're all quite sad, and it's quite chaotic. Good word to describe it. And then Mary Poppins comes, and everything's dark and cloudy. And Mary Poppins comes, and it's sunny, blue skies. Everything starts getting better as soon as she arrives.
How's
did you feel when you found out that you got the role?
I screamed, then I screamed, and then I screamed, and then I got a wooden spoon and pretended that it was a microphone and started running around the house. Yeah, that was fun.
And how did your friends at school react?
I couldn't tell them at first because it was quite hush-hush, because it was a big film and everything. So I would be on set dancing with Dick Van Dyke, and then I'd go to school and be in maths class, and then I'd be writing and I'd be like, oh, I'd be remembering all these things, and I couldn't tell them. And then as soon as they told them, they were all so excited and really happy for me.
And had you seen the original film?
Yes, I have. It's my favourite film, fun fact. So I was very excited.
And what's been your favourite part about being part of Mary Poppins and the whole thing?
Shooting the scene Triple Little Light Fantastic. It's this beautiful dance number with so many talented dancers, and it just really is so exciting to watch it and actually remember that you were a part of it, and it was so amazing.
Emily is our new Mary Poppins. What do you think is so magic, not just about Mary Poppins, but about Emily Blunt?
Emily is the perfect nanny, practically perfect in every way. She just fits the role so incredibly well, like a glove, and I couldn't have thought of a better person to play her.
Of course, the Banks family still need Mary Poppins. Why do you think the world as a whole still needs this character so much?
Because with all of these things going on, politics and all of these touchy subjects, Mary Poppins just lightens the day. And if you've had a bad day at work, you can just go sit down on your sofa with some chocolate, because chocolate makes everything better, and watch Mary Poppins and just imagine all of these incredible things happening to you. And honestly, it probably could happen one day, because if you believe, then it will happen.
Oh, it's a phenomenal experience. I mean, like, I couldn't put it into words how magical it feels. And the first Mary Poppins was such a big thing for me, and to be part of this is just such a privilege.
Can you tell us a little bit about what it was like working particularly with Emily, and what makes Mary Poppins such a magical character?
Emily is just such a talented actress, and she's practically perfect in every way as Mary Poppins. And Mary Poppins as a figure to the kids is just amazing nanny who just saves their home and their family.
Who was the best dancer and singer on set?
Oh, I can't. Let me think about that one. I'm not going to say myself. I know I'm not the best and all that talented people. Lin-Manuel was such a brilliant dancer, as well as a rapper and actor and singer. All the Learys were amazing. Emily was amazing. The kids were amazing. I mean, I wasn't that great, to be fair, but yeah, it was just amazing.
Can you pinpoint one moment that was the most exciting bit for you?
Most exciting bit, like meeting everybody and on the very first day, all the big stars, and just like seeing how the movie's magic would just expand and flow throughout the movie. It was just such a great experience.
What do you think people are most going to take away from this Mary Poppins event?
Oh, just to keep your loved ones close to you, because they're your loved ones, they're your family, you need to keep them close to your heart.
To that family, can you talk a little bit about working with Ben and Emily, your family in this one?
They're such great people to work with. I mean, Ben, as our father, is the chemistry is just amazing. And Aunt Jane as his sister, and our aunt, it's great fun to be around.
So there's a lot of magic in it. Magic and discipline, a great combo, right? But yeah, especially 2D animation, which we haven't seen in years, where it's really done by artists, every inch of it, pen and ink and drawn, and it's beautifully done.
Also, the actors, the child actors in the movie are so good and so unchild actory that I think kids will really relate to it, because they seem just like any kid getting caught up in these fantastic adventures. And the movies and the song also seem to bring out a lot of emotion in people. I think almost the movie could be subtitled, "Why is Daddy crying?" Because, I mean, as soon as the movie starts, people just fall into these memories of themselves as children. And that's what the movie is about, is once again realizing the things that you loved as a child are real and are meaningful. And it's a wonderful kind of sentiment to be able to put forth.
They wouldn't have done the movie if Emily hadn't done it. So, and even from the moment she lands, you feel like you're in good hands. So,
They both have a wonderful way, as does Rob Marshall, of being extremely confident and yet in a way that is not disconcerting. And that confidence that they have like syrup, it poured over us, yeah. So we were able to also join yeah. in.
And Rob is one of the best people on earth to do this kind of thing. I mean, he's so good with actors, they all think they can fly now. So Emily has perfect pitch, and that's kind of a miracle of these days and age.
Yeah. And then, of course, for Lin, we just kept realizing, oh, my God, we can add a couple of more words into that line because he's just able to get so much out at one time. Because when we write them, I sing them, and I'm just exhausted. But once he came to make a demo, we realized, oh, we can really, let's go even more wild.
Can you talk a little bit about why now is the right time to return to the magic of Mary Poppins?
I think 54 years have passed since Mary Poppins left, and all those kids who experienced her wonder the first time have grown up. And a big theme of our film is grown-ups forget. They forget that magic and wonder that can be in your life. And when you go through troubled times, to have that magic return is sometimes the most important thing. And so we have two generations now able to watch it at the same time. I think it came out really well. And I worked with tremendous collaborators in Rob Marshall, a brilliant director, Mark Shaman, Scott Whitman, composer and lyricist. And with them, with all of us working together, we all felt we had each other's backs. So that.
Can you talk a little bit about our leads, particularly Emily, and what makes her such an astonishingly perfect fit for this character?
I don't know how she does what she does, but every line that I wrote, she took and made that much more special, that much more thoughtful. There's something in her eyes. When she's smiling, you see the sadness of Mary Poppins. When she's serious, you see the humor. She's always playing every dimension of the character as you go through it. And it's a tremendous performance. It really, it's going to stand the test of time, I think.
Talk a little bit about how important it was to have a partnership with a storyteller like Rob Marshall.
Rob is a brilliant director and as sharp an eye as it comes when it comes to reading a script and bringing out the best qualities of it and getting rid of the stuff that doesn't work so well. It was an amazing collaboration. I loved working with him, and I love him as a person, and I would be happy to work with him, you know, as many times as he wants, you know, down the road.
I'm curious what you're most hoping audiences take away from this adventure.
That when we go through bad times, it's easy to forget the magic and joy and hope that makes life special. But you can get through the fog and you can get to the end where you see the light again and there is happiness and hope at the end of the day. And that's really the message of the whole film.